Now, I'm happy to introduce you to one of my favorite Pittsburgh people, Danielle Spinola.
Thank you for having me.
We are in her lovely tea shop in Millvale called Tupelo Honey. And Danielle, thanks so much for hosting us. I love the shop, always has such a happy feeling about it.
Thank you.
And I wanted to just ask you a couple of questions about how you got into the tea business and why you have such a passion for tea.
Sure. Oh, go ahead.
I
have my own. Mm-hmm. So in 2002, yes, I took a trip to China. And I had a really great cup of tea in the back of the Jade Buddhist Temple in Shanghai and left and decided that that's what I wanted to do for my life, with my life, I guess.
One trip.
Wow. One cup of tea changed everything.
One cup of tea changed everything. So.
And why? Tell me, what was so revelationing about it?
I think when we got there, like, just the feel of the whole place. So, we went to the Buddhist temple and the monks came out and the gongs started going and you were just in this like super holy place that was very sacred. And then we got dumped into a gift shop because that's what you do. And
yes, right.
In every tourist,
even in a Buddhist temple.
Can't forget those.
Got dumped into a tea shop. Oh. And in the tea shop was, we got paired with this lovely young woman who was probably no more than like 17 or 18, and she spoke impeccable English and taught us all about the teas that she was serving, and they served us tea.
Yeah.
You know, obviously we bought tea.
Right.
good salesperson, too.
Right. And we walked out the door, and I said, my husband, who was then my boyfriend, I said, I think this is what I want to do with my life. And he's like, well, I think you need to pay off some student loans first.
First things first,
Let's
right?
pay off some student
Very
loans.
Very practical.
Yeah. Very practical.
And how many years ago was that?
2002. So
2002.
What is that?
17 years. In my book.
Yeah. So came back, did some, you know, research on tea and whatnot. And I've always been a tea drinker, never a coffee drinker. So I just started researching like different teas and how you could do a business. Like, how could you do this?
Sure, you and then try to make money at it.
Right.
Sure.
Got it. That's you got to do something. Got to pay the bills.
Exactly.
And then I started. Kind of exploring with herbs and spices and teas and blending, and just grew from there. Kind of got into like my own feel of how to blend, and
yeah, that's kind of your a signature thing you do here.
Yes.
At Tupelo, you blend custom teas for people.
Yes, you have one.
I do. I do have a custom
Please
tea.
Tell us about that.
I do. It was such a wonderful experience, and I have a custom tea for my tour company called Passport to Pittsburgh. And to
what a
sip,
coincidence.
Yeah. And to sip while dreaming of adventure is the tagline under
it. Isn't it?
It is. So, you know, I want
it.
I wanted
to.
It's well, some spice.
I want to know the secrets.
It's a black tea base, and it's got some spice and some warmth.
And everything nice.
Some warmth to it, kind of like me, because when we worked on it, it was about bringing out your personality in your tea.
Right.
So, how'd that work out?
Really great.
It really did.
She has some turmeric in it, which is, you know, one of the big buzzwords right now.
Nice anti-inflammatory. I know a couple
exactly.
things.
Exactly. So we're going to do that today while we're here. And Alan is a guest host today. And I would like it if you would blend him a custom green tea.
The talking machine
green Look
tea.
Look at that.
Yeah.
That's why I'm here.
Do you think we're going to be able to do a green tea weather report? Will you be able
I'm
to
hopeful.
Have our...
Yes. I'm hopeful.
With the new blend.
I might show the new blend.
New blend from that? Tupelo Honey. And you can give a nice little...
I don't make promises lightly. So
no, right.
Happen.
I follow through.
I like it.
But anyway, let's get back.
My friend first.
Exactly. So let's get back to your story about did you pay off your student loans?
I did.
And then how did you get your first tea shop? It wasn't always here.
No. So once I got everything going with, you know, paying off the student loans and I ended up having a couple babies.
Happens in life.
Yeah, I kind of threw a monkey wrench in it for a little while. Mm-hmm. But you know, while I was at home with my children, I just kind of kept thinking about it. So I decided to launch an online store, and that lasted a whole hot minute. Because after that long, after I launched the store, I ended up being in Sam's Club with my kids, and I was checking out, and this woman in front of me started yelling into her phone and hangs up her phone and turns around and says, never start a business. And I said, well, what business are you in? And she said, I own a coffee shop. And I said, oh, interestingly, I'm in a similar business. I have a, you know, I do tea. And she said, do you wholesale? And I have done sales my whole life, and you never say no. So I said, yes, of course I do. And she said, here's my card, call me. And so I went home, and it was like this whole, like, how am I going to service this account? And so I basically pretty quickly figured out that servicing an account like that, you need to be unique and different, and you need to give them quantities that are lesser than what you could get at a coffee, like with their coffee supplier. Sure. So
right.
That's how I got into custom blending. I started playing around with herbs and spices, and I blended her a custom chai. And then people from her store started going to other stores and saying, we want you to carry the chai from that store. And wow. But I don't,
yeah.
I don't, once I do a chai for a company, that stays with that company.
It's theirs.
It's yours.
Doesn't repeat.
It's exclusive. Correct.
Wow. Right.
So so then I started blending for their wholesale, yes. And that grew our wholesale account. And then through the wholesale and word of mouth, I was able to get into the Pittsburgh Public Market, the first one under the 16th Street Bridge.
Really?
So that's really where I launched the retail side of this business.
And was it always determined.
Yes, I was.
Was it always called Tupelo Honey Teas?
Yep. Always.
Oh,
yep.
Fantastic.
So we were under the 16th Street Bridge at the public market. Mm-hmm. And then when they, I left probably about 6 or 8 months before they moved to their newer location. And I moved to a place in Allison Park close to my house and close to my children.
Sure.
And I did that for about 3 years with the intent. I've been looking in Millvale, so I grew up here, and this is kind of my hometown.
You like the area. It's very
yes.
Quaint. It's a quaint little city.
It's, well, yes. Our Gertie's Run, my mother is a Gertie. It's named after my mother's family. So we've been
That's
here
cool.
since pre-Revolutionary War. So it's like, yes. I wanted to be here.
That's a couple years ago.
A personal
connection.
Hot minute.
Yeah, a personal connection to Millvale.
Yes.
Yes.
So mm-hmm. I knew I wanted to be here. I had been looking at property here since about 2008. So while I was in Allison Park, I had started to do the farmer's market here when they started a farmer's mm-hmm. market, just to kind of dip my toe back into the market
sure.
here and get people used to seeing me in the community
sure,
again.
Get the word out.
Get the word out that I was looking. And through that farmer's market, I got connected with the people who started the library.
Yes.
And they had started a whole movement with Millvale to an eco district plan and
really?
Revitalization between them and the MCDC, which is the community.
So you
development
wanted to ride the wave.
So I got in. Yeah.
Yes.
I got in, and that's how I ended up here.
I know, and I love it. If when people come to visit you, which I hope after watching the show they will see that your shop is directly connected to the Millvale Public Library.
Yes.
And you are welcome to take your cup of tea and go over and read a book and relax.
Or bring your book
or
over
bring
here.
Bring your book over here mm-hmm. as well.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a wonderful, it's a...
Symbiotic.
It is a great relationship, a great relationship. So,
good choice of verb.
Good. Yes. Okay, so... we know you love the location.
Yes.
And I know that you have some events here. You hold some lovely events here, and I've been to a couple of them.
Yeah.
Do you want to talk about some of the things you do here at the tea shop?
Oh, goodness. So I use the tea shop as kind of a creative outlet for myself. So if it's something that I am super passionate about, I love to do it here because why not, right?
Exactly.
Instead of throwing a party in your house where you have to clean, you throw it here.
Exactly.
And everybody can come.
But you still clean up.
You still clean.
Couldn't get away from it.
So we've done some things. So I'm also a craft beer drinker. And so I am, I love craft breweries. I'm in the Pittsburgh Beer Ladies, which is a group of ladies who go around and drink craft beer, and we have a great time.
Wait, I need to join that group.
You do need to join that group.
And maybe do a show about that.
That would be amazing.
Okay,
they would love it. We're actually
coming attractions, folks.
We're taking a little trip. We take little trips and
uh-huh.
all that stuff. But anyway, because of my love of craft beer, I started doing Octibeer Fest. So having local breweries brew with our tea. and then craft, actually they're the homebrewers. It's a complete homebrewer event. So
you infuse the beer with tea.
They brew with it. They actually brew with it. So in a lot of ways, you know, people will make a cup of tea like we did here.
Yes.
And then they'll pour that into your beer. But
the Vietnamese green tea was delicious.
The problem with that is if you're a beer drinker, you know you don't want to water your beer down.
Sure.
Right. Dilutes the potency.
Dilutes your beer.
Yeah.
So we have worked with craft brewers, actually Gristhouse, which is in our backyard.
Yes.
They're doing a can release tomorrow, and one of the beer that they're can releasing has some of our tea in it.
Congratulations.
Yes. Thanks. They've made all kinds of different things, and I've been working with them since before we opened.
Yeah.
Just kind of like, you know, I'll go to them and say like, hey, you want to do an event? And then they'll brew something. So, but this event in particular is for mainly home brewers. And so they come in, we donate the tea to them, they donate the beer and the brewing process to the event, and then the money goes to a charity. So
how nice. That sounds awesome.
Yeah, and then we did a Hygge New Year, which was great. I think we were talking about that, right? I think you were going to try and comment.
I was going to try. Hygge New Year. Tell us what that is.
Yeah, so every year we do like a wellness event on the first Saturday of the new year.
Mm-hmm.
And we invite all kind of wellness people. So acupuncturists and Reiki. We had sound therapy this year, meditation, yoga, massage therapy, candle makers, everything. And you come and we try to keep all of the sessions that people take so you can come and learn. I always like to do an informational or, you know, some kind of education part. So that was all free. It's all free. You can come and participate. And then if you want to pay to get a dollar a minute massage, or you want to pay to do your sound therapy or whatever.
Sounds great.
Between here and the library.
And the library.
Mm-hmm. So it's a combined.
And you have that every January?
Mm-hmm. It's the third January.
Is it already passed?
Yep.
It's
the first Saturday of the new year.
Okay, well, what's your next event you have coming up? So we're going to put this up, and your website would have all of these things on there, and we'll put it on at the end of the program so people can...
Thank you. Yes. Actually, Facebook is the best place to go for our events.
Facebook page.
Check our Facebook page. Okay. Tell us that page.
Tupelo Honey Teas. So,
and that's teas.
T-E-A-S. Yes.
Right.
Coming up this spring, we are working with Christina from Apio Idea Apiaries. She's a local, do you know Christina Newman?
Local beekeeper.
Yeah. So Christina and our chef are looking to put together some kind of little tasting event.
You just had a high tea for Christmas.
We did.
And it looked so nice. I wanted to try and come. And I've been to your... bluegrass brunches.
Yes.
Yes, and they're so fun as well. You have that lovely little trio that plays music.
Well, the bluegrass brunches, we had to actually stop doing.
Oh.
We got a cease and desist. So,
You're too loud for the neighborhood.
No, it was more from BMI and music rights. So until we could navigate the waters of all those. It was, even though there were local artists playing their own songs, there was some other things in play, and I didn't have a chance to go through that.
Yeah.
But we do have the high tea or the afternoon tea. We did that for Christmas.
Yes.
And we're looking at possibly doing another one, I think, in May for Mother's Day. So
wonderful.
That'll be something that's coming up.
Yes. Oh, and you have also been a tea stop on my traveling tea party as well.
Yes.
Yes. And the ladies love it. So tell me about... we're going to have to cut there because Kim is, you know. We're going to go, yes. All right.
She's going to make a talking machine.
Yes, no.
I like it.
First of all, I know what I wanted to ask you. I want to ask you about what your opinion is about the health benefits of tea drinking. Because I know Alan will want to know what you think about it.
All ears.
Well, I mean, I'm in the business because I believe in the health properties of all herbs and teas. I healed myself as well.
What did you have?
So back in 2000-ish, my ex-boyfriend left me and then also gave me a really severe case of mono with jaundice. So I ended up in the hospital.
With jaundice?
With jaundice. Oh. I was yellow.
Your color's better now.
Thank you. Yes. Thank you. And so that, after I got out of the hospital, I was told I needed to give myself a good year before my liver was going to be back in check and taken care of.
That is terrible.
And so don't drink a beer, don't bump your side, don't do anything that could compromise your liver.
Be careful.
So, yes. So I went on, I went to my book, which I'll show you when we get to that portion. Yes. It's my book.
Oh, I got to see this.
And
book.
I looked through my
it's
book.
Like an apothecary book.
Yeah. I do. Uh-huh. And in that book, I read about milk thistle and dandelion root. And so for one month, I drank dandelion milk thistle tea. And ate a bunch of really fresh, just cut fresh. I snacked on fresh cut veggies, and in 1 month,
sounds like a healthy.
It was, yeah. And when I went back to my doctor, he fell off of his chair and was like, "I don't know what you did, but liver enzymes are completely normal."
That's fantastic.
Couldn't believe it.
One month. I'm a believer.
So that, in and of itself,
convinced.
I mean, I had always read about all these wonderful health properties
Then
you practice on yourself. So a lot of our teas we blend for health properties.
Yes.
And also taste, because if you don't like it how it tastes, you're not going to drink it, right?
Exactly.
So
makes a good sense.
We have Go Red Heart Blend that we blended for the Heart Association years and years ago for their Go Red Women's Heart Conference or whatever.
Yes. Yeah. The campaign in February.
Yes. So mm-hmm. we blended that, and everything in it is good for your heart and your circulatory system. System and your pretty much everything that goes along with that system.
Yeah.
We have a bye-bye migraine tea that we blended that helps take away headaches and migraines.
Nice.
So we, you know, we
You're
have
very
a
cutting edge
elderberry elixir, which helps with the cold and flu season.
Wonderful.
Trying to think some of the other ones we have. We have Essiac tea. We actually sell quite a bit of that. So, while we don't make any claims that these will cure
see
your doctor exactly. first, make sure. And that's one of the things that all of our girls are trained on, is that everybody knows, if somebody comes in looking for something for health properties or for something, it's very important that you take this tea with you when you go to the doctor and make sure that they know what's in it, because herbs are
it can conflict with other medicines.
Herbs are traditional apothecary. So, you know, before we had medicine, we healed ourselves with herbs, and all medicines come from an herb. So
how did we go thousands of years without antibiotics?
Right.
Tell
exactly.
me about
garlic.
It. Right.
Garlic.
Honey. Seriously.
Tupelo
honey.
Honey and garlic.
Tupelo honey.
Now, before we go over to the mixing room, the blending room, I just want to say that you have a full restaurant here. You serve
cafe.
Mm-hmm. You have a cafe here, and your food is vegan.
Correct.
And
vegetarian.
And vegetarian.
We have some vegetarian things, but our new chef
is
vegan.
How about gluten-free? Do you offer any
We're working on that. Yeah, some of the things we offer are gluten-free. We're trying to include at least one or two items a day that are gluten-free.
So. Okay. Yes, and I've eaten, and everything's delish.
Oh. Thank you.
Yes.
Thank you.
All right, well, let's take a break and head over to the mixing room and mix and develop this fantastic green tea blend for Alan.
This is like the original. This is
funny. Your little original book where you keep all of your blend recipes.
Yeah. Going back to 2002.
Yeah, and mine is in here too. I remember you writing it down.
Yeah, I
yes.
I have it in here somewhere.
Yes, I remember how you did it.
So we're going to go here and we're going to get you your own page. All right, so let me see.
What do you have green that you'd recommend?
Well, your green is, I would say, I mean, gunpowder green is always a good
base.
I'm
good with that, yes. It's one of my
favorites.
But
it's not going to be grassy.
No, I drink
a
China gunpowder.
But this actually would probably be a really great base for like a turmeric and a ginger.
Yeah. I actually throw some turmeric in my China gunpowder.
Well, you're not going to.
There you go.
We're going to take care of that.
What the heck's going on?
So, are you rolling by any chance?
Yes.
Okay, perfect. Sorry if I like.
That's okay.
I just.
You're fantastic.
I wanted to make sure that you got this, and if you needed me to, go up. So the top three shelves.
Here, Alan, you take this. You're going to be talking about your tea and what you want.
The top three shelves are all of our blending herbs. So we can pull any of those down and add them to your mix. I know you're looking for anti-inflammatory, so obviously sure. turmeric and ginger or something we're going to pull yes. down. But if there's something flavor-wise you'd like you could throw a hibiscus in there. It would give it a really beautiful
give
red color.
Give me a
color.
Little hibiscus.
It's going to be a little tart.
That's
Is that okay?
Yeah.
The ginger should cut that.
I'm okay. If you're putting ginger, hibiscus.
I think it'll be delicious.
Yes.
We can also do some other things. So I'm going to get the ladder out. I'm going to start pulling some things down, and I just want you to yell at me anything else you think you want.
I will try my best.
I'm going to put this down. Is that okay?
A little drum roll.
The ladder.
So you have my tea in one of these jars too?
We did. I think I moved it over. It's in a bag now.
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm. I'll take some with me today.
You got it. So I'll hand that to you. You can start putting
Thank
them
you.
Down. Is there anything else that, like, what flavor do you want it to have? Obviously a little ginger and hibiscus. Do you want a little cinnamon in there with it?
You could toss a little cinnamon. Yes.
Like almost like a sorrel? Have you had sorrel before?
No. Mm. If you think that would be fine.
I do think that would be
Toss
fine.
That in there.
She makes you very do. Good suggestions you might not think of.
I didn't think of that.
Right.
I'm going to hand that to you.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Your hibiscus.
Thank you.
How do you feel about citrus?
Citrus is always good. Should we stop at a certain number?
Yeah. Don't worry, I got you.
I'm just checking with you, boss.
I gotcha.
I know you're up in high places right now, so.
Yeah. All right, let's see.
Lemongrass?
Maybe we can put lemongrass in it. Do you like lemongrass?
Yes.
We may not use all these either. So
it just caught my
as
eye.
We, that's what I like to hear. I want to do...
Your idea next.
I want to give you a little moringa. Have you heard of moringa?
I've heard of it.
It's like the new superfood?
Yes.
You need some moringa in your life.
Thank you.
Do you like it sweetened, pre-sweetened, or do you like to...
I like it unadulterated.
Me too. Give me that fiber.
You got it back at you.
Au naturel.
Yes.
Like au naturel.
Au naturel.
I like that word better.
Pass my cup down.
Au naturel.
I like that word better.
Let me get
you ready?
Another cup of this tea.
There you go. There you go. All right.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
We're gonna get a little funky, okay?
Yeah. That's why we're here.
I know.
Tupelo honey.
Tupelo honey teas. Mm-hmm.
So the other thing.
That's
we're
teas with an S.
Yes.
Teas with an S. Do you like that?
I like it. That smells wonderful.
That right. smells really nice.
So what
I'm sold.
Here's what I'm thinking. Do you want me to pick this back up again?
We'll pick up some
okay.
of this.
So what I want to do for you is I want to give you a base of gunpowder green, a little bit of this. This is a green rooibos, which is...
It's green rooibos? I'm familiar with rooibos being red.
Okay, so let me show you the difference.
One will be red and this will be green.
Yes. So
how'd I guess?
You're so smart.
Honestly.
So
Alan,
smart.
It's so, all from the green tea.
6 to 12 cups.
Listen, that's going to go on all of my bags. 6 to 12 per Alan.
Yeah.
So do you know the difference between green tea and black tea?
Yes.
And
how it's processed.
Right?
Yes.
So green
it's more
tea.
Extensively processed. And cured than the green tea is.
So what is it that about the green tea that makes it green?
Chlorophyll.
she's good.
She's filling in for you.
So, I needed that help.
Similar to how green tea is just picked and dried,
mm-hmm.
and black tea is
roasted,
picked, and oxidized.
Oxidized. Gotcha.
So they crush the leaf to allow the oxygen to get into the leaf.
Sure.
That's what turns it black. So green rooibos has the chlorophyll left in it, and it's earthier. And you can see there's still even some flecks of red in there.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. But red rooibos is completely oxidized.
And it smells sweeter. Completely different and has a sweet smell. Yeah, mm-hmm. That's why I had to do this smell test.
The smell test.
Yes, I'm familiar with that.
So what we're going to do is we take this green rooibos and we use an organic flavoring. We put a little bit of orange flavor on there.
Ooh.
So that'll
give very exotic.
Give you a little citrus punch.
Okay.
So we're going to do our gunpowder green with a little bit of this green rooibos just to give you a little citrus punch. I'm going to throw some moringa in there. So moringa... it's kind of an earthier flavor, but it's gonna mask and it's gonna go right into the green, and you're not even gonna realize you're drinking. I mean, by itself, it's not bad. It's actually just has like a greeny tea taste to it.
Mm-hmm.
But this mixed into the gunpowder green, and I think is gonna give you like just give you a little, couple extra
a little boost,
some extra vitamins,
a little depth.
Whoa, I'll take those vitamins.
And then the rest of the things we have here, you were expressing your one of lemongrass, which I think is a great mix.
Yeah.
Especially if we're going to use a little bit of orange.
Sure. It'll help bring it out.
The hibiscus pairs really nicely with lemongrass, and so does the ginger and the turmeric. Like, we can put
so
all
these
together.
So we're actually good. You could toss all eight different things in there.
I can make this work for you.
Just in how much of each one, and you'll get to taste.
Yeah.
I can't wait.
Let me put my blending apron on, so, because, you know.
Oh, boy.
That's how you know it's about to get real.
I can sense it.
Wash our hands up. Oh, yeah, that'd be lovely. Thank you, Jess.
Wow, what a great help here.
My assistant, Jess.
Hi, Jess.
Hello.
Thanks for helping today.
Let's get her on camera one second.
Okay.
Very classy.
And I think you were wearing the same apron when you mixed mine.
I always do. This is my blending apron.
This is your blending apron.
This is the one that started it all.
There you go. Tradition.
Tradition.
I'm honored, Kim. Thanks.
Oh, my pleasure. I'm thrilled to have my own blend, and I know you being the tea lover that you are, you're going to really enjoy having
your
own blend.
Yes.
Let me tell you how wonderful it is to have staff that have a brain better than yours.
So I've been doing these blending classes for how long, right? And I'm running back and forth and back and forth to get the water. And last blending class, Jess comes over with a pot. And she's like, hey, do you want me to just bring you some water over this?
Brilliant.
Yeah.
So smart.
So you hold blending classes now.
We do.
Yeah, cool.
That's something we've done for a long time. We don't advertise it as much. And we're actually in the process of getting a new website. So our website currently doesn't have all that information, but we're going to be putting it onto the new website.
Stay tuned.
Gotta stay tuned. All right. So.
Let's see what even happens here.
What happens? What is she doing? Let's get our trusty scale.
Very scientific here.
I know. A little bit of this, a little bit of that.
We were talking with Nate Pantaloni at Dobra.
Yes.
Who was a chemistry major.
Was he?
In college. And how tea is truly some basic chemistry.
It really is.
It really is. So you have your scale, you have your bowls, you're going to
measure
it. Look
at this.
Going to measure it and do the whole thing.
We're a whole thing.
Yes,
all right. Something was on there.
All right. We're going to actually have you do it. How about that? You want to come around and wash your hands?
Yes.
Okay. Woohoo!
Come on around.
Oh, boy.
How about those apples?
Oh, boy. There's going to be no living with him.
Just wash your hands up there. Is your head getting big?
Too late.
It's all right. Too late. Green tea has gone to his head.
I like it. Head. And then there's paper towels right here.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thanks for getting me started.
You're welcome.
All right.
Make sure they're nice and dry.
I don't want them sticking to my fingers.
You don't need a stick.
I'll dig it up to the elbows.
There's a garbage can right over there.
All right.
Okay. So I'm going to be your Vanna White. I'll just keep your recipe jotted down for you.
What letter is this?
This is G for green tea.
All right. Let me.
All right. So what you're going to do is we're zeroed out here.
Okay.
With all of our blends, we always start with about an ounce of the base. and then we go from there. So we're going to start you out with an ounce of green tea. So you're just going to dump that in.
I'm a little nervous.
Don't be nervous, I swear. You can't mess it up. Go ahead and dump it in there. A little bit more. Good?
Good.
Yep, back off just a little bit. That's why we wash our hands.
That's why you're here?
I am here.
Help me.
There you go. All right. So this is an ounce of green tea, of the gunpowder green. And it's interesting because depending on the fluffiness, and you'll see as we go along, an ounce can be a whole lot or a whole little. The other thing...
And these are curled up.
I was just going to say...
I know.
I was just about to talk about that.
I understand.
Look at you.
You didn't, so I had to jump in.
So this is a rolled leaf. So when they...
Let me try.
When they dry them. Do you like it?
Yeah. Very tasty.
When they dry it, they roll it into a... That's why it's called gunpowder, because it looks like a piece
It's like a little ball, and it just expands. It opens up like your hand.
Mm-hmm. Right? All right. Yep. You're going to dump that right in there.
What?
You're going to dump this into there.
Your mixing bowl.
We always dump from... From
the measure to the mix.
I didn't know that. Now I do.
Measure to the mix. All right. Make sure we're on zero.
I see zero.
Sometimes it jumps around a little.
I noticed that jump.
So, all right. So we're gonna flavor this with the orange. We don't want to overpower it. So
less than an ounce.
Do a quarter. So you'll see.
Go up. Give me a hand.
So where we are.
You got the eye.
You are. There you go.
Perfect.
That smells so. So
doesn't
wonderful.
Yes.
Yeah,
so
orangey. Yes.
The other thing too is, and so this is a quarter to a full ounce.
Mm-hmm.
The other thing you have to know is that tea absorbs all flavor, which is why we don't wear any scents in the shop, why we don't carry anything with scents. So what's going to happen is, because this has a flavor to it, it'll start to seep into some of that, and it'll make
Mingle.
The tea real nice and
nice.
Round.
Mm-hmm.
So go ahead and dump it right in. Now this is the part that's super fun.
Okay.
With each mixer we add in, you're going to love your tea.
Okay.
And how we do that is we do a little mix, and we just kind of give it a toss. Okay.
Whoa.
And the idea here is that you want to mix the tea, and you want to use the warmth of your hand to kind of release some of the flavor so you can start to smell how it's going to taste when it's all together. So but what you don't want to do is baby Huey your tea, which is... Because I get people in that want to like
crush it.
Crunch it.
Yes.
You don't want to crunch it.
So gently.
Gently
Alan.
Mix your tea. And yeah, and you kind of get it nice and warm in there. There you go. And then you want to take a sniff.
Wonderful.
You like it?
I like it.
Okay.
And we can always add more. So you can always add more. You can't take anything else.
Exactly.
So we always
start
we start with the low amounts of things of how I think, you know.
Exactly.
I've been doing this long enough, but.
Yes.
So that's a beautiful mix. All right. Next, we're going to add our next mixer in, which is the Moringa. And we just want a little tad of this for the flip.
Another quarter?
I would do an eighth of an ounce of it.
Look how fluffy this is. Yeah, that's very
so,
few
what
flakes.
Is the Moringa? Moringa is a tree.
How are we there?
Nope. You gotta see, it's fluffier, so it's a little bit more. Oh, it's jumping around on us. Hold on, that's definitely
not. Do it again.
Let's do it again. Moringa is a tree that is out of India, and it's also known as the tree of life. People in India use all the pieces of it, and it's healthy. Like every piece of it does something for your body. So talk about health benefits.
I do. I love that. Thank you.
Okay.
Easy.
So there's an eighth. And the thing about it is you remember the quarter that we did of the heavier one?
Yes.
See how fluffy this is?
It's much larger, yeah.
Correct. Mm-hmm. So even looking at that into there, what I want to do actually is I'm going to cut it back.
I knew
so
you
our
would.
scales only goes to an eighth, so we're going to have this, and that'll be about a 16th. And I need to start writing this down.
Yes, before we forget.
I'll let you write.
I'm going to write. You do that.
I can mix it.
Okay, you can throw it in there and start to mix it.
I will do that.
You know, smell your hands and make sure you like the smell.
I love it.
Let me smell it. Oh, that's good. That's good. We might have to pump up our citrus a little, but we'll get there.
I'll trust your judgment.
All right. So what's the next flavor that you want to have come out of this?
Lemongrass.
Lemongrass?
Okay. See, I listened to you.
You did. Mm-hmm. I like it. So take a sniff of that.
Wonderful.
You like it? Mm. All right. So lemongrass tends to be one of those super fluffy. It's super fluffy. 16th. I wouldn't do 16th. If you want, really want this flavor to come through, let's do a quarter. Let's see what a quarter looks like.
Whoa, a quarter.
Yep, give me a quarter. We can always take it out. Let's see.
Whoop. I might be too
there. You
much.
Go. No, you're right at a quarter.
Popped it.
Look at you.
Getting I learned. Good at it, Alan. I learned. You got a good teacher.
Getting a good eye.
Yeah. So, again, we look at our ratios.
Yes.
It's really important. We don't want one thing to overpower.
Oh, right.
You know?
We got to cut back.
You want to cut back on that?
You be the judge.
How lemongrassy do you like it?
Just a hint of it.
We can come back to a quarter.
Could we?
Yeah, because we can always, we're at a quarter. We can go back to an eighth. You can always add more. You can't take it out.
Well, that's what you taught me, so I'm with you.
Okay. So let's throw that in there and give it some love.
All right. Will do. Yeah.
Mix that up a little bit more.
I will. I just...
Yeah, give that some...
What an art this is.
It is.
It really is.
Such take a smell.
Yeah.
Mmm, they smell. Mmm.
Very flavorful.
Mm-hmm.
This is like playing in a sandbox right now.
Mm-hmm. I do love that.
I just love the process.
It's delicious. Okay. So, the next thing, what's the next flavor you want to
have? Turmeric.
Turmeric? Now, turmeric is a root.
Yes.
And it adds some...
And it discolors your whatever you have. Napkins, table, glass,
fingers,
skin.
Yeah. It's good for you, though.
Definitely.
It is. So...
A great anti-inflammatory.
The only thing I'll tell you about this is...
Little.
I would do a little bit of it.
You're on that pattern.
Yeah. Well, the problem is... This is going to overpower all your other things. So I'm okay with you, I'm okay with you adding it in, but I think we should save it for last. So let's put your ginger or whatever else you want
put
in there.
Put that and then
we'll kind of like, it'll be a dash at the end. Do you know how when you cook, you add a dash
yes.
at the end?
Yes, a pinch of this.
So the other two things we have left are three. Ginger, cinnamon, and hibiscus. Are we tied to all of those, or do you want to let any of them go?
No, I like them all.
Okay.
We'll stay with plan A. Very
ginger?
Good. Yeah.
Okay. So I think...
We got to watch. This doesn't overwhelm.
Yeah, this one will. So, but I would do a...
Are we at the pinch stage with all
no,
these?
No, I would do...
An eighth?
Let me see what a quarter looks like. Because right. this is actually a heavier herb, so a quarter is a lot. I mean a little. Sorry. So that's about a quarter.
You got a quarter. Mm-hmm. Good eye, huh?
Yes, listen, you're getting so
you're,
good at
you're
it.
Gonna have to get a job here.
Oh, you're the second shop owner that has asked him.
Will you pay me in tea? I'll drink green tea.
I would love to pay you in green tea. I would love to pay you in green tea.
I'm more expensive than that. Sorry. I just look easy.
So I think that's a decent...
You think it's good enough to put in?
I do.
Because we can't take it out?
I think you're going to be fine.
All right, I'm a little nervous.
All right, don't be nervous. All trust. Right. Trust.
I trust.
I do think we need to pump up some orange in the lemongrass, but we'll see. We'll see at the end.
All right.
So we got the lemongrass and the ginger is the next one. You get a quarter of ginger.
Smells pretty darn good.
What do you think?
Good.
That ginger really comes through.
Yeah, it does. What a mix this is.
Fantastic. Cinnamon always just kind of brings out the ginger a little more. Here, put that in your mouth. Don't bite it right away, but all right. Give it a minute, and then you can start chewing it. It turns into a piece of...
Yeah, I see.
Mm. I love it. That's one of the perks of the job, too. You get to eat it.
I'm hired.
So with this...
Less is more.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And you don't want it to overpower either.
So
you still want all the things to come out.
Lightly.
So an eighth of an ounce is probably good.
All right. Mm-hmm. Oh, way too much.
You almost did an ounce there.
Mm-hmm. Oh, it's heavy.
I got heavy on that.
It's okay. You just want a little taste of it.
Perfect.
As if I've not been doing this for a long time.
You have some experience.
You think. All right, dump that in there.
All right.
Mix her up. Look how pretty that blend is.
I got to mix it in there.
Mm-hmm.
Look at this combination.
I know, it's lovely. Got good color variation.
Who would have thought this?
So our ultimate goal is... with every scoop that you make, that you get an even distribution of all of the things in your tea.
I'm going by look right now.
Mm-hmm. And with every scoop, you're going to get about an even distribution, huh?
Yes.
I think so.
All right. So let's do our hibiscus. So there's a lot of tea in there. And so normally, like this, if we would go with a really small ratio... you're not going to taste it. This is going to, just warning you, this is going to tart your tea. It's going to make
I'm
it
okay a, with that.
You're okay with
yeah,
that?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
I understand tart.
Okay.
So does it compete with the citrus?
It actually enhances citrus.
Okay.
Put that on your tongue.
I still have the cinnamon in here.
Me too.
Do you want to spit it out?
Mm-mm.
Or you want to eat the cinnamon?
I want to chew it.
I like to chew the cinnamon, but.
Hmm.
Mm.
Very good.
Mm-hmm. You like it? Okay.
About an eighth?
Mm-mm.
Quarter?
I would measure at least a quarter in there. Let's see what a quarter looks like.
All right. Let's do this.
Woo. It's like eating a lemon.
Mm-hmm.
A little over.
Yeah, a little over that.
Okay. So there's a quarter.
I think that did it. You got the touch.
That is so tasty.
Now, looking at that to that, if you really want a nice hibiscus flavor to come through, I'd probably do a little bit more. If you're okay with it just being a background color and a very light flavor, then this would probably be okay.
A little bit more.
You can always add it later.
You want a little bit more?
A little bit more right now.
Let's do 3/8 of an ounce.
Okay.
Okay. So go ahead and put that in.
Okay.
And you know, hibiscus is also really good for lowering blood pressure.
I've heard that.
Mm-hmm.
Look at this colorful mix.
Mm-hmm. Wait until it brews up. It's going to be gorgeous.
Thank you.
And I'll smell your fingers.
Mmm.
That smell good?
Wonderful. The secret talking machine mix.
Oh, I like it. I like that. You have to name it at the end. So
yes. Well, it's definitely going to be the talking machine mix.
Oh, that's a good mix.
Look at that.
That's going to be beautiful.
Put your touch on it. I'm an amateur.
All right. So now we're going to do our, we're going to add the turmeric as our last little punch.
Mm-hmm.
And then we're going to taste it. And we'll alter from there. We can see kind of where we are flavor-wise. I have a few ideas that may need to happen, but we'll see. I've been wrong before.
No, I trust your judgment.
So this is
completely.
This is a this root turmeric tends to have like a.
It's strong.
Mm-hmm. A strong flavor to it.
It'll overwhelm. You don't want to
overwhelm all of that. Correct. So
just a touch.
Mm-hmm. So we're gonna measure out. What I do on these is we'll measure out an eighth.
There's an eighth.
And then because my scale only goes to an eighth,
we take then part of it.
Take half of it back.
Well, we're gonna take more than half of it back. We're gonna go to a 32nd.
Whoa.
Whoa! How about those math skills?
Wow.
Only on certain days am I that bold.
I'm glad today's the day.
It's very pungent. You can smell it though, so you don't really want that overpowering.
Correct.
I agree. Yeah.
So we're gonna take back 3/4 of that.
Wow. What skill set here?
32nd. This is just, you know.
You're off the charts right now.
Boom. take me to the
outer
space.
How about take you to the next boil this tea? I'm gonna mix it.
Just mix that in. So this is cut small enough that when we were talking about
they'll be mingled
your
in
ratio,
there.
Correct. You're okay. Not gonna get a whole ton of them, but you'll have
enough.
I'm trying
to mix it up.
Mm-hmm.
Since Jess was really great about getting us cups and tea bags here.
Excellent.
I have some ideas. Now, I want to taste.
What's your idea?
I want to taste this. We may have to, I'm thinking cinnamon may have to come up a little bit and orange, but we'll see. And maybe lemongrass too.
Whoa. A trifecta.
We will see. I always steep a little heavy whenever we're tasting so that
I'm
we can
excited
make sure that we
about
get
this.
Everything.
Listen, very exciting.
I'm excited too. I really want this to be on the weather report for tomorrow.
Yes,
because
we're getting
3 to 6 inches.
Everyone will be tuned in to see the weather report
tomorrow.
The loose leaf
green tea weather report has a new edition.
Okay, so here's the.
I'll talk about Tupelo honey teas.
I like it.
Come to Millville.
Come to Millville. So what's going to end up happening is we should start to see your. Your hibiscus come through.
So it's not going to have that real green color, is it?
It's going to a little bit pink. Come up a little
bit
pink.
Yeah, the hibiscus will give me that.
Now, the turmeric, I'm interested to see what the hibiscus and the turmeric do together.
So. Yeah. Look at this mix.
Beautiful, yes. Alan.
I'm honored. I made the book.
Okay, so here's what's going to happen. Let me go get us a...
I like your glass mugs, too.
Thank you.
They're similar to mine.
They are similar to yours. You know what? We do a blue tea that's really cool.
Really?
It's called Winter Blues. And I like to serve them in these because it's really...
It's colorful.
Mm-hmm. Turns nice and pretty blue.
What a good helper. Look at those spoons.
I know. These are my favorite. They're nice and tiny.
Look, it is getting a little.
Mm-hmm. It's getting pink.
I'm gonna show you.
I'm amazed.
Uh-huh. So, you okay with that green tea, man?
Yeah. I'm feeling okay with that.
All right, good. Here's what I wanted you to be able to see is, you can kind of see in there how it's starting to turn pink.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And you'll see.
It's coming out.
You see it coming out.
Yes.
Of the tea bag.
I see that as you moved it.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
I love that. It's a very meditative process.
Yes. Which steep it 2 to 3 minutes?
We're gonna steep this one a little bit longer.
5 minutes.
We're gonna let this steep for a little while. So when you mix, so traditionally with like a green tea, you wouldn't steep as long. Although I have to be honest with you.
Go ahead.
I do leave my tea in all the time, like my tea bag.
You're kidding. Look, doesn't it get bitter?
No, my tea bag never leaves.
Whoa.
Never leaves. But that's only because I have an issue with. I like things real strong.
Okay.
So.
I can go light and fluffy.
You can go light and fluffy. So normally we would pull this, you know, you'd pull your green tea after about 3 minutes or so.
Sure.
But because we have so many herbs in here and we really want to give them their proper steeping time, we're going to let it sit for a little while longer.
I'll think about that in the morning.
You got to let that sit a little bit longer.
Look at the color.
But it's beautiful.
It's going to get a little darker too, it should. Mm-hmm.
Look at that.
I'm gonna let that give it a minute.
No, thank you for doing this.
Oh, I'm excited. It.
The Talking Machine Secret Green Tea Mix.
See, you might be the talking machine in Bethel Park, but I might be the talking machine in Walmart.
The lean, mean talking machine.
I met my match. Yeah. I met my match.
The lean, mean talking machine tea.
Yeah.
I knew I was trouble when somebody heard me through a building. They could hear my voice through a building.
It just cuts through.
Called me and said, I can hear you in the building.
And you go, I'm not stopping.
I said, nobody ever claimed I was the quiet one.
Yes. Understood.
Okay. So let me let this sit for
It's looking minutes. Wonderful.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I think it's a nice color.
It is.
It's a beautiful color.
It's going to come up just this really lovely pink color, and I have a feeling the turmeric isn't going to do too much to it.
No, it might just be a very light
But see, you
turmeric.
Can still see...
Yeah, there's a little hint.
A little striation of the red that comes out from the hibiscus.
Yeah.
I love that.
It's cool.
And I always dunk my bag.
Do you?
I do all the wrong things.
That's okay.
I squeeze my bags.
This is your shop.
You're allowed.
I do all the wrong things.
It's right for you, Danielle.
It's right for me.
Yes.
Well, I'm a rebellious rule breaker, so this will work out well.
So am I. This is why we get along.
We're perfect back here. Let's shake it up.
Just shake it up.
When can I sip this? Come on, the
I know,
anticipation.
I'm just like killing you with
making you wait.
I'm a patient man.
I really know the suspense.
I want it to be the proper steep. This is our first one, so
yes.
That one's coming up. You can try it, but it's not going to be there just
All right,
yet.
I'm a little nervous.
It's not going to be there just yet. Let's see what it tastes like. You're making me nervous.
Wonderful. Very good.
Well, let me see.
All right,
listen,
let me see.
I think you're pulling my chain a little because I know there's stuff that needs to be changed in there.
No. I think it works. We put quite the mix.
That actually is really
yeah,
tasty.
Yeah, I'll take it like it is.
Oh, delish. I like it.
Very flavorful.
I'm surprised.
No, it is. It worked out. Even the turmeric,
just
being a taste of it.
That's just enough.
And the lemongrass... And the hibiscus definitely comes through.
Mm-hmm.
It's tart, but not too tart.
That's because the cinnamon tones it down.
As per Danielle's conversation.
Yes, the cinnamon always turns.
This is wonderful.
I got to
keep sipping. I don't care what you say. I'm shaking it up.
Squeeze your bag. Don't be afraid.
I always squeeze the bag.
Be
afraid. Here,
be a rebel.
Watch.
Squeeze your bag.
There, I do all the time. When
be
my
rebel.
Tea's done, I
you're
do it. Where do I put it?
Squeeze your tea bag?
No,
oh,
you're
I
not
always
supposed to
squeeze my
I
tea
know.
Bag.
I do. I get that last little
you
bit.
You got to get the last little bit out of there.
Yes.
But you're not supposed to. You're supposed to.
We broke the rules.
Listen, I break all the rules.
Rules are meant
I'm glad
to be
I come to Tupelo Honey Teas.
That actually is really tasty.
Ladies,
cheers.
Thanks for enjoying my taste buds.
Talking Machine Tea.
Talking Machine
That's
Tea.
It. We got Talking Machine Tea.
It's Great. Almost like a coral color.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
The yellow with the red.
Good eye.
Fabulous.
Kim, you're the best. Danielle, my new friend,
you.
You're the best.
No, that was so fun.
Thanks for the assist, Jess, with the water.
Yes, Jess.
Here's to Jess.
Here's to Jess.
And the process.
And
such
the process.
The process was... Off
yeah.
the charts.
You got to come
Better
back
than
here
I could even imagine.
Got to come back and blend your own.
Yeah.
I know.
Thank you. Yes. We're drinking it.
Are you sure you don't want a little more ginger pop to it?
No, that's like a great flavor.
You're
it's
digging
the
it the way
is.
It is?
Yeah.
Okay.
I think it's so cool. Yeah, you didn't have to make any adjustments.
I really
You adjusted
was,
it up fine.
I totally was thinking we're going to have to pump
No, just
up
your
things,
experience
so really
with cutting back on certain things made it all work.